Birth defect surveillance programs assess, describe, and count pregnancy outcomes for a population within a given geographical area within a given period of time, such as 1 year. In this video, we will provide an overview on how to monitor pregnancy outcomes for a population-based birth defect surveillance program. A population-based surveillance program consists of a population of births in a given geographical area collected during a given period of time. The first step is to define the geographic area that your program will monitor. This area of interest is known as the catchment area. It can be a country, a region, a community, city, or town. A population-based birth defect surveillance program will focus on collecting all pregnancies affected by birth defects occurring among a population that lives in the catchment area. These could include elective terminations of pregnancy due to fetal anomaly, etopfa, stillbirths, or live births. Most programs usually include at least live births and stillbirths with birth defects. Another component of population-based programs is the need to define whether a mother of a baby born with a birth defect is a resident within the catchment area. Most birth defect surveillance programs consider resident mothers as mothers whose primary address is within the catchment area at the time of delivery. So, with this definition in mind, there are two main points to consider regarding residency. If a resident mother gives birth outside of the catchment area, whether or not this birth is affected by a birth defect, ideally this birth should be counted because the mother is still considered a resident. If a non-resident mother gives birth inside the catchment area, her birth should not be counted in the surveillance program because the mother is not considered a resident. The next step is to determine which data sources are available for your program to use for capturing stillbirths and live births with birth defects within the catchment area. Data might be available from health facilities that capture all births and stillbirths, vital records such as birth and death certificates that might contain information about birth defects, referral treatment centers for individuals with birth defects defined by the age inclusion criteria used by the registry, administrative databases such as hospital discharge records, home birth data, and/or another source from which a stillbirth or live birth with a birth defect can be identified. Once you have established your catchment area, determined the birth defects and outcomes of pregnancy that will be monitored, and identified which data sources to use, you are ready to calculate the birth prevalence of birth defects among the population. Using numbers from the collected data, you use a standard equation to calculate the prevalence. First, count the number of all live births and stillbirths to resident mothers. This number is the denominator. Next, from those same births, count the number of stillbirths and live births with birth defects. This number is the numerator. Finally, divide the numerator by the denominator and multiply the result by 10,000. For example, if in 1 year 450 stillbirths and live births with birth defects are divided by 15,000 total births and then multiplied by 10,000, the result is 300 cases of birth defects per 10,000 births. One could summarize this result as 3% of the total births are affected by birth defects. In this example, data on pregnancy outcomes are used to estimate and describe the prevalence of birth defects within a catchment area and within a time period of 1 year.